Hey everyone, in this video we're going to talk about how to export transparent video from Cartoon Animator and import it into a 3D environment in iClone. The scene that you see right now is actually composed of 2D animated characters composited into a 3D project. To achieve this, we're going to export using the popVideo format, which uses alpha data and is used by both Cartoon Animator and iClone to export transparent video. Let's take a quick look at our character's animation for our project first. You can see him shredding away on his guitar, and this animation will be the only thing exported, with the background transparent. Next, we'll open up our render export options and choose the popVideo export format. There are two important options here, to export with preview size video, and also to render popVideo with high quality. The high quality version will consume more resources and may slow down playback in iClone, while the preview quality can be used to resolve that problem if you encounter it. Finally, we'll just choose our export resolution, which is indicated by the black square frame surrounding our character, then choose the project length range and export. Once we're done, let's use the Smart Gallery in iClone to spice up our scene a little bit by adding various props. You can easily search and find content from any content pack you've purchased in the past in the Smart Gallery. In this case, I'm using props from a pack called Stage Equipment, which you can find in the Content Store. I'll also provide a link in the description below. Next, it's time to import our popVideo. I'm going to hold the Control key and click and drag with my left mouse when importing it in order to ensure the resolution. You can see that it will import as a 2D plane and even cast a shadow on the stage. From here, I can enter in an end frame manually and toggle playback looping on the timeline. We can play back our animation just to test it out. Next, let's tweak our scene a little bit to make our popVideo character fit in better with his surroundings, and also add some additional effects. First, I'm going to give our guitarist some bandmates by holding down the Control key while I click and drag on the Transform gizmo. This is a quick and easy way to make duplicates in iClone. Once they've been positioned, I'll then head over to our Scene Manager and turn off our main directional light in order to start with an image-based lighting template. Under Scene, you'll find an Atmosphere subfolder that will contain a number of IBL templates. In this case, we're choosing this blue-tinged one that is included in the Light Studio content pack. After we activate the IBL in our Visual tab, then we can adjust the strength to get a nice dark blue ambiance to start. From there, we can also turn on HDR, which will allow us to add some bloom effects to the lighter parts of the scene, and also to tweak the overall visual tone. Once we've established our settings for the ambient lighting in our scene, it's time to add some spotlights to really make our characters shine. You can add a spotlight from the Create menu and reposition it using the W and E hotkeys to toggle transform and rotation gizmos. Spotlights also include a number of other useful parameters such as range and angle, and you can also adjust the shadow strength and color of the light itself. After I've got my spotlight parameters set to the level I want, I'm going to bring in a transparent PNG, which I can use as a glowing sign. If I control and left mouse drag it into the scene, it will import as a prop plane that I can then manipulate and animate in various ways. In this case, I'm adding a glow map to the glow texture channel. The advantage of having a glow map is that you can animate the strength value throughout your timeline to make it seem like the light is pulsating. The lights on either side of our sign also contain glow maps, so I'll increase the strength of the first one to give those lights a little glow effect. If I want to copy those same material values to the other surrounding lights, I can simply use the copy paste command at the top of the material section, and paste the same material to each one. Finally, I'm going to add in a popcorn effects particle effect. You can find a number of embedded particle effects in the particle folder under Set, and you can also purchase additional packs from the Content Store with more effects. I'll search for this welding spark effects and bring it in right in front of our main character. Don't forget to enable Simulate so you can see how the effect changes you make look in real time. There are tons of different parameters here that you can adjust in order to simulate a sort of firework effect. Once I've found the combination that looks the best, then I can just again hold Control and click and drag to duplicate my fireworks as well. For the finishing touch, we can add a slight depth of field effect on our scene camera. Once the camera is selected, you can then select the depth of field effect, pick a focus target, and then pick the main guitarist at the front. You'll see him come into sharp focus while the background guitarist becomes slightly blurred. We've done this at the first frame, and since we're going to have a slow camera pan from left to right, we can also go to our last frame and then move the camera slightly right for a more dramatic look. That's all there is to it. As you can see, it's easy to utilize all sorts of different effects and props in iClone to further enhance your transparent video exports from Cartoon Animator. I hope you learned a lot in this video, and be sure to check out our forums at forum.reallusion.com, and I'll see you in the next one.